Baruch Fleischman here at the Tikkun Elevator Kollel, and we're about to learn at the Zohar for today. This is the Matuk Medivash. Let's go over to the Zohar and try to find our place here. Our place is on some page, Samach Base. I think that's where it is, no? Wrong, it's on page Samach Gimel. So here's what the Zohar says. It says, Vayikaku v'yishlichu osecha b'bor. They took him and they threw him into the pit. This is where I'm supposed to be down here. Just one side. It says, Vayikahuhu, and they threw him into the pit. It says, Kadei the Farish Pasuk Zen, in order to explain this Pasuk, Rabbi Yehuda Pasuk b'Shabbos b'Shevach HaTorah, and Rabbi Yehuda begins with the praise of the Torah. V'amar Masha Kosev, and he writes, what is written, Torah Hashem Tamima, the Torah of Hashem is pure. Pirish, HaTorah HaTamima, She'esek Bo Ha'adam Ba'olam Hazi, it means the pure Torah that a person is working on in this world. Meshivas Nefesh, it has the ability, Goremis Lo, it causes for him, in other words, it causes. Chayim Ba'olam Hazi, V'shes Ziv Olav Nafsho, and also, not only does it bring him life in this world, but it saves his soul. B'tachias amazing at the time of the revival of the dead, kadu farish v'azo, as we're going to explain. Kama is alone the b'nei nosh of the hishtadlo of raisa. How important it is for people to learn Torah. The kol man the hishtadlo of raisa, because everybody who does, lehevei le chayim ba'al medende ba'al medaasa, this person will live a life in this world. His life would be alive in this world and in the next as well. Going on. One more time here. There we go. The focus of Olam Haba. V'zacha betrin alman, and that person merits the two worlds. V'hu zacha lehenanis b'shnech olamos. V'alficha v'manda ishtad ba'raisa. So even a person we're talking about who works and Torah, studies Torah, and he translates, but he doesn't learn it for its own sake in the proper way. But that person, even so, then he will get a great reward in this world. And he's not judged for his lack of enthusiasm or his inability to be able to make to connect, as Rabbi Mimran would say, be the davik to Hashem. But the Chazik said, look at like this: Orech yamin b'mina v'smolo u'b'smola osher v'kavu. The length of days is in his right hand, the hand of Chesed, and the left hand osher v'kavu is where physical things are put together, where a person has wealth and honor. Pirusho orech yamim havtocha zuchu ne'emra. So this promise has been stated. B'haku d'shtad b'raisa d'shma, in regards to a person who learns Torah, because he loves the Torah and Hashem. That's it. Deis le orech yamim b'haku alma debay orchin de yamim. Sheyeshlo orech yamim, this person has length of days, ba'olam haba, in the world of the future, the world of eternity. Shehu olam hanitzri, the eternal world. V'sham hu so the richos yamim, and that is where we find the secret of length of days. V'inun yomin, inun yomin vadai, and these days are actually days. That's what he says. V'osam ha'yamim, that we're talking about, heim yamim shal kiyum b'vadai. So they're along the lines of, they are days of staying alive, of being alive. Avachal the yamim shal olam haba, that's the olam of the next world. That's the place where real life is found. But the life that's found over here, hazeh heim kitzel over, they're like, it's like a constantly passing shadow. But kalim be'efes, they're, let me see if I got this right, sail over kalim be'efes tikva, they are like vessels with no hope. But it's not a lomer, because we know that we're not going to live forever in this world. Ratzon lomer shelo ya'amar adach b'ma'achu she'ani oisik b'Torah, a person shouldn't say like this. So since I learned Torah, because it says about that person, the person, the length of days. Then I'll know for sure, I'll trust. Then I won't die in this world. But that's not true. Nobody in this world will live forever. And so therefore the Pasuk is talking about Orach Yamim, which is the time, the world beyond physical life. Vomer od v'tamen, it says like this: Ihu rachatzu dekutcha berichu, sham chul sachar shalat b'tachon. So over there in the next world, that is where we find the reward for a person's faith, hamiti, the true faith, shal ma'ala, because that's where a person connects with the true faith, which is found up above. The true faith is compelling when you make contact with that inner reality. So Rebetamen ihu rachatzano dekutcha berichu, sham chul sachar. So this is the reward. Shall habitachon amiti shall ma'ala. This raches bar nash b'haihu alma d'shtat b'raisa. This is the reward. Shabata ha'adam, because the man has trust. B'hakodesh bor b'olam haza, in this world as he's working the Torah, and you don't necessarily, you're not going to live forever here. Even though you're touching eternity when you're learning the Torah, of Esek B'Torah, V'estakpa B'haku Alma, K'day L'Hizchazek B'Olam Haba, but that's the reason why our faith is so important, because we learn our Torah here to strengthen ourselves for the next world. So it says, V'Smola Osher V'Kavod, that part of the Pasuk that said in the left, that's where we'll find wealth and glory. This particular concept of learning from the side of the left is the reason why some people learn in order to call themselves a Rav. They won't be important. So therefore, these kind of people don't have the same kind of reward. So then the Amr Amisha Ozibatur Shalolishma, a person is learning not for the right reasons. Gamku Agar Stav, so but he also has a great reward. The Shalva, and also peace and tranquility is lay by Alma. Zachar tov v'shalva dahein the osher v'kovod yihye lo b'olam hazeh. So a person will have a great life in this life, but it's not talking about the next life as much. B'kol man de'ishtad b'raisa d'shma. So let's take anyone who learns Torah in the name of learning Torah, just for the sake of the Torah itself. It's a kadnafik mahay alma. When this person leaves this world, yishin kishe yifne nihye nifter, when a person is excused, Mizeha Olam, and then the word his avoda is done in this world. V'yalichu also, and he will transport it mina bais lekever, and he will go from his home where he was living into the grave. Arisa ozlo kamei v'akrazas kamei. The Torah comes before this person and announces before that person. He announces to all. V'aginas ale the lo yikruvum b'hade ma'regem dedinan. And this Torah that the person is learning, a magenis a love, and it is a shield for this person. Show yikruvah of a love of balchadinim nachaziko, that the masters of din, the agents of din, will not approach this person and make accusations against him while he's still on his way to the grave, or not in the grave, lachaziko, to hurt him. Hashkiv gufa bekvora, he pronounced it bekivra, when the body is now laid in the grave. He netras lay. Keshechaguv shochev bekever. Now it's in the grave. He shomeris alav. That is, that Torah guards over this person. Shelo yagobo zarim, so that foreign elements cannot get attack this body bekever in his grave. Velo yehiyah nidon bechabud bekever, and he will not be judged by the vapors, little vapors that are left over in the kever that could come and cause problems. Kad nishmasa azla the istaklo the mesiv la archum. Kushahan nashama holeches la alos began aid now. You're in the ground. The Torah that you have is protecting you from the chibud de kever. So he comes over and he says now, Kushahan nama holeches la alos began aid. Now the body is in the ground and now the nishama is on its path to Gan Eden. Shalmata, that is, now he says there is a Gan Eden that is down below. Derech hachechelos the Gan Eden ad ma'alo l'chelachzor l'makomo. So let's read again. He says that first, on the passageway from the Gan Eden, Shalmata. So this means that there's more than one Gan Eden. There's a Gan Eden in Olam Asiya. Berek HaChechelos, and it has to go through the different palaces, the Gan Eden, Shalom Allah, to the upper Gan Eden, Lachzor L'makomba, to come back to the place that this neshama originally came from. So he says, Ihu Ozlo Kameh Dahahi Nishmasa. So he, Holechas Lifnei Ozach HaNeshama, that is, the Torah goes before that neshama. Bekamataren Itabru. So as this passage is taking place, a kamasha, a kamishar, many different gates, segurim, that were closed, nishbarim, are broken down, niftachim, and open up, mifnei haterach holechas lifnei haneshama, because that it comes before, and because of the Torah that this neshama had been involved in learning, ad shenik nesses, the makoma, the god neid elyon, until it comes to its place in the upper Gan Eden. B'kayim b'cholecha the barnash ad yisare b'zimna the yukuma mesaya the alma. So now this Torah, v'omedes ala adam, it stands on the man, or let's say by the man, ad sheyisare the v'yakum b'zman, until the person becomes awakened, and v'yakum b'zman sheyakuma mesi ha'olam, and the body then will come back at the time that will be risen up, will shayakumu meisei olam, that the resurrection of the dead, that the dead will come to life. Ve'ihi milpa sanigori alei, v'hu melamedes zechus alav. So this Torah is always telling good things and saying all the good things about the person that we're talking about. Ha'hud de'chzev, this is the meaning of this pasuk. V'yisalechka tancha olsach, in your travels, I will be comfort for you. When you lay down, I will guard against you. And when you wake up, that's what you're going to talk about. Now let's see what the Matuk has to say. So you can understand that as you're traveling through your life, that this Torah will be a comfort for you. As it stated, the Torah went before the person, at the time he was excused from this world, and when he lies down, it will be there to guard him. The time that his body is now lying in the grave. Because in the moment that the body is put into the grave, that's the moment that the body is judged. Ki oz bizmanahu nida naguf bekever, that's when the judgment starts. Okay, then oraisa agina olai, and that's when the person's Torah becomes a shield for this person against the accusations that will come to him. There is no man ever lived without sin, and those accusations are there. V'hakitzosi hi tesichecho, and when you wake up, I will be your conversation. Come to the Itmar Pirush, and he's Pirusho, and it, as it has been stated, and he explains. Bezimna di sa'arach b'meisi olbach min yafro, in the time that the dead will come up out of life. Bezman she is ordered of yakitzach b'meisi olbach min yafro, at the time that they're aroused, when they awaken and they come out of the ground. He tesichecho, this will be your conversation. Le mehevi sinaguri rabaloch, that it should become a defender for you. As az ha-Torah tihya meilitz yosha alecha l'lamad alecha zuchus, in order to teach you, for you. And this is Baruch Fleischman. This is all the time I have left for today. Thank you very much for listening. This is the Tikkun Elevator Kollel.